Next question. Question number 51. Consider the following statements regarding Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, which is IPCC. Statement 1. It was established by the United Nations Environmental Programme and the World Meteorological Organization, WMO. Second statement, India is a member of IPCC. Question says, which of the above statement is R correct? A, B, C, D, there are four options. Option C, 1 and 2, both are correct. So your right answer is C. Let me clear about the question. IPCC was established by the United Nations Environmental Programme, you can say UNEP, and the World Meteorological Organization, WMO, in 1988 to provide policymakers with regular scientific assessments concerning climate changes, its implications and potentials future risks, as well as to put forward adaptation and mitigation strategies. Next question, question number 52. What are the impact of global warming transition from 1.5 degree centigrade to 2 degree centigrade? 1. Coral reefs would decline by 70 to 90%. Number 2. Increase in crop yields. Number 3. Additional people could be at risk from malaria. Quote. Option A says only 3 is right. Option B says 2 and 3 are right. Option C says 1 and 3 are right. All of the above. Option C is the right answer. Let me clear about this question. Impact of global warming transition from 1.5 degree centigrade to 2 degree centigrade. It gives different results, like number 1. Decline in crop yielding. Unprecedented climate extremes and increased susceptibility could push poverty by several millions by 2050. Number 2, coral reefs would decline by 70 to 90% with global warming of 1.5 degrees centigrade, whereas virtually all 99% would be lost with 2 degrees centigrade. And third, additional people could be at risk from malaria because mosquito-related disease will be increased. So, statement 1 and 3 are right. So, your right option is 1 and 3. It's C. Next question. Question number 53. Consider the following statement regarding dead zones. Statement 1. Dead zones, you can say hypoxic zones, are areas of the ocean, occasionally in lakes and even rivers, where oxygen has fallen to such low levels that most aquatic life cannot survive. Second statement, dead zones are never reversible even if their causes are reduced or eliminated. Question says, which of the above statement is correct? There are four options, A, B, C, D. Your right option is option A. Only one is correct. Second option is wrong, because dead zones are reversible if their causes are reduced or eliminated. Next question, question number 54. Sanyukt Rashtra Convention to Combat Desertification, UNCCD, ke bare mein nimlikhit kathnon par vichar karein. Kathan number 1. Yah ekmatra antarrashtriya star par kanuni roop se badhyakari dhancha hai jo marusalikaran ki samasya ko dur karne ke liye sthapit kiya gaya hai. Kathan 2. Convention vishesh roop se shushk, अर्धशुष्क और शुष्क उपनम क्षेत्रों को संबोधित करता है जिन्हें शुष्क भूमि के रूप में जाना जाता है. स्टेटमेंट 3 कहता है 2020 से 2030 तक रेगिस्तान और फाइट अगेंस्ट डेजर्टिफिकेशन यानी मरुस्थलीकरण के लिए संयुक्त राष्ट्र दशक के रूप में घोषित किया गया है. प्रश्न आपसे पूछ रहा है उपरोक्त कथनों में से कौन सा सही है. हैं चार ऑप्शन है ए बी सी डी. आपका सही विकल्प होगा ए, जिसके अनुसार पहला और दूसरा कथन सही है, तीसरा कथन गलत है. तीसरा गलत क्यों है वो सुन लीजिए. कथन में लिखा है कि 2020 से 2030 तक रेगिस्तान और फाइट अगेंस्ट डेजर्टिफिकेशन में संयुक्त राष्ट्र दत्तक के रूप में घोषित किया गया है, जिसका सही रूप है 2010 से 2020 न कि 2020 से 2030। इसलिए तीसरा स्टेटमेंट गलत हुआ, पहला और दूसरा सही है और इसके लिए सही विकल्प हो जाएगा ए। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 55। कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट रिगार्डिंग ग्लोबल एनवायरमेंट फैसिलिटी। स्टेटमेंट वन सेज इट इज़ अ फाइनेंशियल मैकेनिज्म established under the 1992 Rio Earth Summit. Second, it is managed by World Economic Forum. Third, held here every 3 years, the assembly is the GEF highest governing body. Question asks, which of the above statement is or incorrect? There are four options, A, B, C, D. The right option is option B. Only 2 and 3 are incorrect. First statement is right. Second statement said it is managed by World Economic Forum, which is wrong. Actually, it is managed by World Bank. So, second statement is wrong. Third statement says held every 3 years, the assembly is the GEF highest governing body. Actually, after every 4 years, it will be held. So, held every 4 years. So, third statement is also wrong. That's why the question, the answer of this question is option B. Next question, question number 56. Which of the following are environmental conventions under Global Environment Facility Financial Mechanism? Number 1, Convention on Biodiversity, CBD. Convention to Combat Desertification, UNCCD. Third, Framework Convention on Climate Change, UNFCCC. Quote, there are four options, A, B, C, D. The question asks, which of that are related with financial mechanism? All of the above are correct. So, your right option is option D. Let me explain about the GEF mechanism. The GEF, Global Environment Facility, serves as a financial mechanism to 5 conventions. Number 1, Convention on Biological Diversity. Number 2, United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Number 3, Stockholm Convention on Persistent Organic Pollutants. Number 4, United Nations Convention on Combat Desertification and Minamata Convention on Mercury. So, there are 5 conventions are related with this mechanism, and here all the 3s are correct with this question. So, your right answer is D. Next question, question number 57. Which of the following frameworks related to protection of ozone layer? Number 1, Vienna Convention. Number 2, Montreal Protocol. Number 3, Kigali Agreement. Quote, there are 4 options, A, B, C, D. The right option is option D. All of the above are correct. Let me explain. Question number 57, D. Vienna Convention for the Protection of the Ozone Layer, 1985. It acts as a framework for the international effort to protect the ozone layer. Number 2, Montreal Protocol, 1987. It aims at reducing the production and consumption of ozone depleting substances. Number 3, Kigali Agreement to amend the Montreal Protocol, 2016. Its aim is to phase out hydrofluorocarbons, a family of potent greenhouse gases, by the late 2040s. So, this is the clarification of the question. I mean, this is the details of all convention and protocols with agreements. Next question, question number 58. Consider the following statement regarding air pollution and carbon emission. Statement 1, black carbon is a potent climate warming component of particulate matter formed by the incomplete combustion of fossil fuels, wood and other fuels. Second, brown carbon originated primarily during the combustion of organic biomass and coexist with black carbon. Number 3, Black carbon is the carbon stored and sequestered in coastal ecosystem such as mangrove forest, sea grasses, meadows or intertidal salt masses. Question says, which of the above statement is are correct? There are four options, A, B, C, D. Your right option is option D because all are correct. Question number 59. Marpole Convention 1973 is related to. There are four options, A, B, C, D. State option A, Convention for the Prevention of Pollution from Ships. Option B, Convention for the Prevention of Pet Coke as Fuel. Option C, Convention for the Prevention of Single-Use Plastic. Option D, Convention for the Prevention of Ozone Layer Depletion. Your right answer is option A, Convention for the Prevention of Pollution from Ships. Let me detail it. International Convention for Prevention of Pollution related with Marpole Convention 1973. The International Convention for the Prevention of Pollution from Ships is the main international convention covering prevention of pollution of the marine environment by ships from operational or accidental causes. The Marpole Convention was adopted on 2nd November 1973 at IMO, International Maritime Organization. Next question, question number 60. Consider the following statements regarding National Clean Air Program, NCAP. Number 1. It was launched by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Changes. Number 2. It is legally binding. Number 3. It is a pollution control initiative to cut the concentration of particles PM10 and PM2.5 by 20 to 30% by 2024. Question says, which of the above statement is are correct? There are four options, A, B, C, D. Your right option is option C because only first and third statements are right. Second is wrong. Let me detail it. National Clean Air Program, NCAP, is to be implemented in non-attainment cities. These cities are chosen on the basis of Ambient Air Quality India 2011-2015 and WHO report 2014-2018. It is not legally binding. Second statement says it is legally binding, while actual thing is it is not legally binding. So, statement 1 and 3 is right and second is wrong. So, your right option is C. Next question. Question number 61. Consider the following statement regarding Central Pollution Control Board, CPCB. Number 1. It is the statutory organization constituted under the Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1974. Second, it functions under the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Question says, which of the above statement is are correct? There are four options, A, B, C and D. Your right answer is option C, 1 or 2. Both are correct. Let me explain it. The Central Pollution Control Board of India is a statutory organization under the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. It was established in 1974 under the Water Act 1974. The CPCB is also entrusted with the powers of function under the Air Act 1981. The CPCB have the power and do the function are number 1, to promote cleanliness to streams and wells in different areas of the states by prevention, control and abatement of water pollution. Number 2, to improve the quality of air and to prevent, control or abate air pollution in the country. Number three, coordinate the activities of the state board and resolve disputes among them. Next question. Question number 62. Which of the following component monitors by system of air quality and weather forecasting suffer? Option A, UV index. Option B, black carbon. Option C, benzene. Option D, all of the above. The right answer is all of the above. Let me clear about this. SUFFER. SUFFER is an acronym of System of Air Quality Weather Forecasting and Research, which was first launched in Delhi in 2010 during Commonwealth Games. The system is jointly run by the IITM and the India Meteorology Department IMD, and the forecasting model is running on a supercomputer in IITM called Aditya. SUFFER monitors UV index, PM10, PM2.5, mercury level, black carbon level, sulfur dioxide level, ozone level, nitrogen oxide level, carbon monoxide level, benzene, toluene and xylene level. Next question, question number 63. Consider the following statement regarding National Air Quality Index. Number 1. It transforms complex air quality data to various pollutants into a single number, index value, nomenclature and color. Number 2. There are 6 air quality index categories. Number 3. Samir app has been developed to display air quality index at a city and receive complaints. Question says, which of the above statement is our correct? A, B, C, D. Your right answer is option D. All the above are correct. Let me detail about this question. Number 1. In National Air Quality Index, the index is a display with color and some numbers. Like, there are 6 quality of color and number details. This, when air quality index display dark green color, it is good. The index level is now 0 to 50. When index display light green color, it means index number is 51 to 100. It is satisfactory level. When index plate display yellow color, it is moderately polluted. The index number is now 101 to 200. When index shows orange color, it is poor level of air quality index. Now it has 201 to 300 index level. When index display red color, it is very poor level of air quality index. Now air quality index has 300 above, 300 to 400 level. When it shows dark red color, it is severe polluted conditions. Now index number has 401 to 500 and more than 500 level. So this is the air quality index which I have mentioned in this statement. It transforms complex air quality data of various pollutants into a single number, index value, nomenclature and color. This is right. There are 6 air quality index categories which I have already said. It is green color, light green color, dark green color, yellow color, orange color, red color and dark red color. There are 6 air quality index categories has different quality of pollutants level. Pollutants covered under National Air Quality Index are sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxide, lead, ozone, PM10, PM2.5 and carbon monoxide. Question number 64. Consider the following statements regarding nitrogen pollution. Number 1. In India, nitrogen emissions grew at 69% from 2001 to 2011. Number two, agricultural soil contributed to over 70% of nitrous oxide emissions. Question asked, which of the above statement is are correct? There are four options, 1, 2, 3, 4. It means A, B, C, D, four options. Your right option is C, 1 or 2, both statements are correct. Let me give me another extra information. There are 3 to 4 hot spots in India, nitrogen hot spot in India. Its name, Delhi NCR, Sonbhadra in Uttar Pradesh, Singrauli in Madhya Pradesh, and Talcher Angul in Odisha. Next question, question number 65. Which of the following is our impact of nitrogen pollution? Option A, blue baby syndrome. Statement 2, vitamin A shortages. Number 3, induced function of the thyroid gland. And 4, increase the carbon content of the soil. There are four options, A, B, C, D. Your right option is A, which shows statement 1 and 2 are correct and rest 3 and 4 are wrong. Let me explain. Number 1, blue baby syndrome. How blue baby syndrome is working? Blue baby syndrome is a disease which occurs in infants due to soil pollution. Excessive use of fertilizers, pesticides, and other nitrogen compounds increase the level of nitrates in soil or water. From soil, it enters the vegetation, nitrate also, and enters through drinking water, and it causes blue baby syndrome. Next, vitamin A shortage is also the effect of excess of nitrogen compounds in soil and water. So, 1 and 2 statements are correct. While third statement says induced function of the thyroid gland, it is wrong because it decreases the function of thyroid gland. Fourth statement, increase the carbon content of the soil, it is also wrong. It is decrease the carbon content in the soil. So, in this question, statement 1, 2 is right and third and fourth are wrong. So, your right option is A. Next question, question number 66. Which of the following mandates related to biological diversity? Number 1, Cartagena Protocol. Number 2, Sharm el-Sheikh Declaration. Number 3, Nagoya Protocol. Quote, there are four options, A, B, C, D. Your right option is option D because all of the above are related with biological diversity. The Cartagena Protocol on Biodiversity to the Convention on Biological Diversity is an international agreement which aims to ensure the safe handling, transport, and use of living modified organisms resulting from modern biotechnology and may have adverse effect on biological diversity, taking also into account. Sharm el-Sheikh Declaration is announced in 2018 in Egypt. It is also related with biodiversity. Third one is Nagoya Protocol. The Nagoya Protocol on access to genetic resources and the fair and equitable sharing of benefits arising from their utilization to the Convention on Biological Diversity, also known as Nagoya Protocol. On access and benefit sharing is a 2010 supplementary agreement in the 1992 Convention on Biological Diversity. So, these are the connection with biological diversity with Cartagena Protocol, Sharm el-Sheikh Declaration and Nagoya Protocol. So, your right option is option D. Question number 67. The Global Tiger Initiative, GTI, for globally conservation of tiger was adopted in. There are four options, A, B, C, D. Your right option is A, 2008. The Global Tiger Initiative 2008 is a global alliance of governments, international organizations,
civil society, the conservation and scientific communities, and the private sector, and includes organizations like the World Bank, the Global Environment Facility, etc. Next question, question number 68. Consider the following statements regarding elephants. Number 1. Elephant is national heritage animal. Number 2. It categorized as endangered under IUCN list. Number 3. Project Elephant was launched in year 1992 as a centrally sponsored scheme. Question asks, which of the above statements are correct? There are four options, A, B, C, D. Your right option is option D. All of the above are right. Let me clear about all these. Elephant is under Schedule 1 of the Indian Wildlife Protection Act 1972 and is Appendix 1 of the Convention of International Trade in Endangered Species of Flora and Fauna sites, CITES. Karnataka has the highest number of elephant. So these three statements is very clear that elephant is a national heritage animal. It is right. It categorized as endangered species. It is also right. Project Elephant was started in year 1992. It is also right. So all the above are right. Next, question number 69. Consider the following statement regarding African cheetah. Number 1. It is a large cat that occurs in southern, northern and east Africa and also in some location in Iran. Second, it inhabits different habitats like dry forest, shrubs forest and savannas. Number 3. Its IUCN status is critically endangered. In question, which of the above statement are correct? This is the question of this question. So you have four options, 1, 2, 3, 4. It means A, B, C, D. The right option is option A, because statement 1 and 2 are correct, while statement 3 is wrong. Statement 3 says its IUCN status is critically endangered. While in IUCN status, it is a vulnerable animal. So this third statement is wrong. Rest 1 or 2 is right, and it is chosen in option A. So your right option is option A. Next question, question number 70. Singfan Wild Sanctuary is famous for. There are four options. Option C, Royal Bengal Tiger. Option B, Lion Tailed Macaw. Option C, Elephants. And option D is Asiatic Rhinos. Your right option is option C, Elephants. Let me clear about this. Nagaland government declared the Singfan Wildlife Sanctuary as an elephant reserve. It is 30th. In number with the approval of central government. Next question, question number 71. Which of the following is not one of the harmful effects of ozone layer depletion on human being? A. Depletion in growth. B. Increase in susceptibility of skin cancer. C. Damage of cornea. And D. Cause retinal diseases. The right option is option D, because ozone layer depletion can cause skin cancer. Next question. Question number 72. Consider the following statement regarding the reason for biodiversity loss. Number 1. Loss of habitat. Number 2. Environmental degradation. Number 3. Introduction of foreign species. Question asks, which of the following statement are correct? There are four options, A, B, C, D. The right option is D. All of the above are correct, because all statements are directly related with biodiversity loss. So your right option is option D. Next question. Question number 73. Consider the following statement regarding a greenhouse effect. Number 1. A greenhouse is a glass chamber in which plants are grown to provide them warm by trapping sunlight. Number 2.
The phenomena of heat build up inside the glass chamber from the absorption of solar radiation is called greenhouse effect. Question asks, which of the following statement are correct? There are four options, A, B, C, D. Your right option is C, because statement 1 and 2 both are 100% correct. Next question, question number 74. Which of the following is on the list of global environmental issues? Number 1, biodiversity loss. Number 2, oil spills in ocean. Number 3, depletion of ozone layer. Option D, all of the above. Actually, all of the above are responsible for environmental issues. So, your right option is option D. Let me clear about global environmental issues. The important global environmental issues are, number 1, greenhouse effect and global warming. Number 2, biodiversity loss. Number 3, desertification. Number 4, depletion of ozone layer. Number 4, ocean drain. Number 4, oil spills. Number 5, dumping of hazardous waste, and so many other causes are directly indirectly affect the global environmental issues. So all of these are mentioned in this question. So your right option is option D. Next question, question number 75. Which of the following types of forest found in India? A, tropical rainforest. B, tropical deciduous forest. C, alpine and tundra vegetation. D, all of the above. All three are found in Indian territory. So your right option is option D, all of the above. Let me giving little bit details. The following major types of forest may be identified in India. Number 1, tropical rainforest. Number 2, tropical deciduous forest. Number 3, temperate broad leaf forest. Number 4, temperate needle leaf of coniferous forest. And number 5, alpine and tundra vegetation. They all are found in India.